test, 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 test. Test, 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 test. Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are on Friday, January 22nd. We have a JV game, JV boys game between the Lake Center Christian Tigers and your host, Garfield G-Men. Tip-off and starting lineups and tip-off are coming up next. Interesting side note here that these teams just recently met. I believe it was 6 days ago, last Saturday, with the G-Men coming out with a win in overtime down in Hartville. G-Men just lost at home to the Mogador Wildcats on this past Tuesday. It was a close game throughout, and they ended up losing the final minute. Starting lineups for the G-Men, we have, looks like number 5, sophomore Max May, number 21, sophomore Evan Janik, number 33, sophomore Carter Bates, number 20, sophomore Vinny Grandizio, number 22, sophomore Jackson Summer. We'll get the Tigers starting lineups shortly. Number 15, freshman Tanner Norman, number 12, freshman Chase Gingerich, number 5, Luke Underwood, number 11, Matt Warder, number 21, Rock Shelton. G-Men win the tip here. May has it at the top of the key. G-Men looked around a set here, crosses over, passes out to Summer. Janik at the top, gives a look, gives a fake pass out to Bates. Oh, good cut there. May couldn't handle it. Back 2 points there for Matt Warder. G-Men back quickly here. Summer with a good look. Couldn't capitalize there. Oh, good offensive rebound. Good offensive rebound there. Looks like a foul by 21 Brock Shelton. Made it inbound here. Oh, good pass there. Interesting call by the ref. Looks like May came back in. Looks like Max May came back in to get it. And can't do that, so. Tigers have the ball. G-Men looks a little bit of a press out. Tanner Norman, good dribble. Oh, good pass there. Number 11. Matt Warder with the basket. G-Men back quickly again. Looking to push the tempo here. Try and get a good look. Pass it to Summer. Summer pump fakes. Runs off the screen there. Foul on the floor. That one looked to be on Chase Gingerich. Made inbound again. Oh yeah, Grandizio didn't want that though. Out to Bates. Bates up. Couldn't capitalize there. Grandizio almost got the rebound. Oh, the Tigers looking to run quick tonight. Number 15, Tanner Norman's a good dribbler here. Look to run into a set. Mishandled it there. He's back in. Quick move there. Good rebound by May. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not. Jump ball. Stays with the Tigers. Shelton to inbound. Out to Norman. Norman in the key. Powers his way in. Good pass there. Couldn't finish there by Shelton. Good block by May. Some refs would call that a jump ball, but not this ref. Norman at the top of the key. Going to use his quick size and quickness to his advantage. Oh, good strip there. G-Man looking. Bates has a one-on-three situation here. Pump fakes. Grandizio looking for a pass. Passes it to May. Summer off that cut. G-Man having a hard time handling the ball here today. Oh, good bucket there. One up strong. The Tigers appealed for a travel, but ref says no. Norman looking pump fakes here. Out to number 12, Chase Gingrich with the basket. He's got two. Summer with a good look. Summer for three. Grandizio there to knock out of bounds. Bounce, Tigers ball underneath the basket coming up here. Shelton inbound, nearing a 5 second call. Out to Gingrich, up to Norman. Tigers moving the ball well here on this possession. They're using their quickness off the dribble and their cutting ability. Oh, good defense there by May. Forces a bad shot. Janik back in transition. Oh, good little pass there. Summer for three. He's got six already. Shooting foul on number 33, Carter Bates. Shooting two for the Tigers, number 11, Matt Warder. This is the first. In for the game for the G-men, number 14, Colin Lysak. In for number 21, Evan Janik. He makes a second. He's up to five already. Jimin looking to getting a set here. May with the top of the key, picks up his dribble, passes it to Lysak. Lysak passes it to Bates. Bates has the ball at the top, out to May. Good post up there by Lysak. Lysak up strong, a little too strong there. Norman using his quick little sneakiness there, and Lysak with the ball, passes it right back to Norman. Good three there by number 5, Luke Underwood. First points of the game. Looking for Lysak on the post up. Couldn't handle it there. Norman back in transition once again. Throws a cross-court pass. Warder on the pull-up miss. Rebound, Grandizio, G-man ball coming the other way. Got numbers ahead. Pass it to Bates in the corner. Bates gives a jab step. Out to May. Up to Lysak. Summer with a look again. Summer for three. He's got nine already. G-men trying to get some change of possession here on the press. Oh, good ball won there by Tanner Norman. Oh, a little too hot to handle there off of Bates and off of Brock Shelton. G-men ball in for the G-men. Number 2, Leo Grandizio. Number 40, Vince Jukic. Out for the G-men. And number 5, Max May. Number 20, Vinny Grandizio. Freshman Leo Grandizio here to run the point now. Yuka's trying to take it strong. Out to Grandizio. Over to Summer. Summer thought about it, goes in the hole, and gets his two. Good drive there. my scoring corrects is correct. Summer already has 11 points. Genizio thought about into the paint. Free layup there. G-Men lead 15-10 with about 50 seconds left in this here first quarter. Oh, good change of direction pass there out to Norman using his handles to his advantage. Out to number 11 with a miss. Number 11 follows his shot and gets a layup that he misses and gets the rebound again. Finally, a rebound by number 40, Vince Jukic. Interesting call there by the ref. Says no foul, that he landed out of bounds. So it'll be Tigers ball. Shelton inbound. Finds a pass there, number 11. Number 11, Matt Warder. Another two. He's up to seven. Summer again. Couldn't get his fourth three-pointer of the quarter. Brings your first quarter to a close. G-Men lead the LCC Tigers 15-12. All right, we're back to start the second quarter. Quick stat check for you. Number 22, sophomore Jackson Summer for the G-Men has 11 quick first quarter points. Number 11 for the Tigers, freshman Matt Warder has 7. 15-12 with the G-Men to inbound to start the second quarter. And for the G-Men, we have number 20, Vinny Grandizio, number 2, Leo Grandizio, number 14, Colin Lysak, number 34, Elijah Hatfield, number 40, Vince Jukic. Normal starting five for the Tigers here. Look to run a set here. Hatfield out to Grandizio on the wing. Grandizio in. Grandizio quick little pass to Lysak. Lysak looks to go up strong. Passes out to Grandizio. Jukic at the top of the key. Jukic using to look his power and use power and speed as advantage. Couldn't get by the man. G-Men really doing a good job of ball movement here. They're not holding the ball longer than about 2 seconds. At the most. Oh, nice little pass in there, Lysak. Fade away, too. G-Men bring out their press again. Thanks to the dribbling of Tanner Norman, they've been able to break it pretty well. Bad pass there by number 5, Luke Underwood. G-Men ball going down. Inbound for the G-Men, number 14, Colin Lysak. G-Men doing a little 1-2 game with the Grandizio brothers. Oh, had Vinny on the cut, but missed him there. Looking to run a set here, trying to maybe get the other side of the court a little more involved here. Jukic and Hatfield just screening for each other. Lysak takes a strong to the hole. Can't finish the floater. Then he foul on the floor, number 14, Colin Lysak. Shelton inbound to Norman. Norman's been doing a good job splitting those double teams. See if his teammates can do that too. A bad pass there behind Norman, but he's dribbling up the sideline. Nice little pass, or so he thought. Good hustle play by Elias. Wasn't able to keep it inbounds. Shelton inbound for the Tigers. In for the G man, number 5, Max May, looking to add some little veteran experience to the JV team, even though he's only a sophomore. Missed three ball by Tanner Norman. Good box out by May. He's down the court. Oh, good Euro step. You won't see a better layup than that most of the time there. 2 points for May, his first of the game. G-men pressure really throwing the Tigers a feast here. Air ball there. Close out. Box out by Evan Janik. G-men moving the ball well. Grandizio thought he had a pass, couldn't get out of his hands. Maybe that's for the better. Janik for three. Janik for nothing. Norman navigates through the traffic, trying to maybe set up a play here for his Tigers. About two and a half minutes through the second quarter, it's 19 to 12 G-men. Oh, good catch and shoot three by Norman. Bank is closed. Oh, good block. About probably a 6-inch size difference there, but Janik was able to block it. Tigers inbound. Lysak and Vinny out for the G-men, and for the G-men, Summer and Bates. Summer with that 11-point first quarter. Tries to maybe try and add to it here. Tigers moving the ball around the key, trying to get some motion going. Maybe a little bit of solo action there. Some pick and rolls and drives like that. Hopefully next time it wouldn't end like that. Bates hard for the key, mishandles it. Jump ball, says the ref. Turnover to the Tigers. Quick hands by May, but he smacks it out of bounds off of him. Shelton inbound again for the Tigers. Refs calls a push foul on number 21, Evan Janik. Got a little too aggressive there with the hands. It's his first, team's third. Oh, good pass there by Norman. But mishandled there by Gingrich. G-man ball, Janik inbound. Oh, good catch and shoot three there by Janik. Couldn't capitalize. Good box out by Gingrich. Shelton inbound for the Tigers. 3 minutes, 40 seconds left in the second quarter in your JV game. First of a two-game set with the Tigers, JV and varsity. Tigers down the floor. Euro steps in. Can't miss. Tigers have had a little bit of a scoring drought here. Started off hot, but haven't been able to continue that. Good pass in there to Bates by Summer. Goes up strong and can't get it. Rebound by Gingrich. Out to Norman using those handles of his. Foul on the floor on number 34, freshman Elijah Hatfield. Two men in for the G-men. Vinny Grandizio and Colin Lysak. Out for the G-men, Janik and Elijah Hatfield. Pretty interesting, the Tigers haven't subbed yet this half. See the three men on their bench, maybe they could go a little bit deeper, but they choose not to. Keep their starting five out there the whole time. Little tie up there between Gingrich and multiple G-men. Jump ball going the G-men way. Lies inbound to May. Tries to maybe slow it down and get a play to run. Get a nice, good scoring opportunity for one of his guys. Dribbles over to the right side. Out to a corner three for Summer, who passes up on the three and tries to penetrate but can't. Out to May. Little into Carter Bates and mishandled there, but finally picked up by Summer, who goes in hard and gets fouled. That foul will be on Gingrich. I have his first, but I also have his team second, and the scoreboard says otherwise. So he'll be out, and in will be number 24, Corbin Osborne. Summer out to May. It's been a good connection as of recently. Bates in hard. Not too tight of an angle there. May with the offensive rebound. 2 points. Oh, Norman's ahead in transition. He's got full head of steam. Gets fouled and the and one. This is first 2 points of the game. Brings us, he'll be shooting one after the and one. Foul on Max May. Norman's had the ball a lot, but only has 2 points to show for it. His team only down seven, so they have obviously a lot of time to make a comeback and maybe change the outcome of the game. Pass by Grandizio, that was a little too low for May to handle. Tigers have a 2v2 situation. Shelton tries a Euro step, but can't capitalize on the free throw. May, good hustle to hit the floor. Bodies hitting the floor everywhere. Out to Matt Warder for three, and Matt Warder drains it. 21-17 Tigers with about minute 40 left to play in this second quarter. Shot good by Summer, but ref says foul on the floor. Leon Norman, his first. Team's fourth. Liza Tindbound for the G-men. Set a cross screen out to Grandizio, out to May. Gets into the paint. A little bit of a questionable call there, and he's done it before and haven't called a travel, so don't really see what the ref saw, but May questions it, and I question it too, but hey, sometimes how it is. Tigers looking to break that hard man-to-man press by the G-man. If you can dribble through the whole defense like that, then you're going to have a good time. Refs decide that it was indeed off of the G-man, so Tigers ball to inbound underneath their own basket. Shelton again for them. About a minute 18 left in the second quarter, 21-17 G-men. Heard a fan calling 3 seconds, and it was about maybe 9 seconds there, and turnover. Lies to inbound to May, coming up the floor for the G-men. Got a minute 5 seconds left. Looking to run one of their plays here. Can't really expect that any of these plays are new to either team since they faced each other 6 days ago. Oh, good hard pass there by Grandizio into May. Powers it up, couldn't get to fall, but he'll be going to the line for two. That's a foul on Matt Warder. His first, team's fifth. May to shoot two for the G-men. Makes the first. He's up to 5 points all this quarter. Actually make that 7 points. Five this quarter. Make that 8-6 this quarter. 45 seconds left. Oh. Underwood passes up a basket to get Osborne a basket. A May picks up his dribble and throws a bad pass, but then works hard to get the ball back and strips it out. Bates picks it up. Bates mishandles it. Bad pass is thrown everywhere. Bates finally gets it. May wisely decides to hold up. 10 seconds left. G-Man looking to get a final shot here. Summer with the layup. They do get that final shot with 4.2 seconds left, but Summer is fouled by number 5, Luke Underwood. Summer to shoot 2. Summer makes the first. He's up to 12. So far he has exactly half of his team's total 24 points. 11 of the 12 coming in the first quarter. He misses, but Bates gets the rebound, then misses that shot. Half-court heave, no good. Brings us to halftime of our JV game. Score 24-19, G-Men leading. Summer with 12 for the G-Men, and Warder with 7 for the Tigers. We'll be back. We're back here as the teams do their final talk. About 30 seconds left in this halftime. G-men lead at the half 24-19 behind 12 points from Jackson Summer, 6 points from Max May for the G-men. Got 7 from Matt Warder for the Tigers and another 5 for Luke Underwood. Made that 6 for Luke Underwood. G-men out here with their starting 5 except for one adjustment. They looks like Max May is getting fixed up on the sideline. Got 14 Colin Lysak, 21 Evan Janik, 33 Carter Bates, 22 Jackson Summer, and 20 Vinny Grandizio. Tigers most likely to keep their starting 5. Looks like Tanner Norman will start on the bench with Corbin, number 24, Corbin Osborne in there to start. Tigers will inbound at about midcourt. See to maybe get a one-shot game here with a down by 5. Moving the ball pretty well right out of the gate. Looking into the post, decided against it. Put the ball on the floor, looking back in the post, good seal there. Couldn't capitalize on the layup, rebound to Bates. Evan Janik with a smooth behind-the-back pass. Bates couldn't handle the rebound. Tried to go up, but got it smacked out of bounds. Lysak to inbound. This little pass by Lysak to Bates. Bates with the fadeaway. Good post move there, but then says thank you for that easy basket. The layup. I got that as his first two of the game. G-men lead 26-19. Underwood tries for his third three but can't hit. Janik up the court. And Elias make that. Summer tries the down low pass to Grandizio that got smacked out of bounds by a couple of Tigers. Summer pulls up from mid-range to Lysak. Lysak might have gotten fouled, but ref didn't call anything there. G-men getting chances, but only been able to hit one shot so far this half. Grandizio, good job to strip the ball there and has it run up the court, goes into the corner, out to Janik. A little high pass there, but Janik handled it. Summer good hustle to retain possession here. G-men to inbound. Let's see what they see what set they come up with on the out-of-bounds play. Yeah, they're just going to throw it back to Grandizio, and he'll dribble it across midcourt here. About a minute and a half gone. G-men lead 26-19. Good little drop-step post move there. Hook shot by Carter Bates, and Tigers look to push it quick, and that they do. Shelton tries to go baseline on Lysak, but can't. Gets it knocked away by Grandizio. Grandizio with about 3 steals here this second half already, if I was going to say. Don't know exactly, but that's what I would say. Good 3 there by Janik. That's his first points of the game. Tigers call timeout with the lead swelling to 12 right before their eyes. We'll be back in about 30 seconds. We're back out of that quick timeout with the G-men still leading 31-19 over the Tigers, with G-Man setting up their getting time to make a game plan and set up their full court man-to-man press. In for the Tigers, number 10 appears to be Nathan Underation. Ref calls a foul on 21 Evan Janik. That's his first. That's his second, team's first of the half. Underation struggles with retaining possession. Bates tried a nifty little bounce pass to Janik that Janik couldn't handle. Warder takes it hard to the basket, misses it, and then gets the rebound and gets fouled, so he'll shoot two. See who that foul's on. Yep, number 20, Vinny Grandizio, his first, team second. Warder to shoot two. Warder hits the first. He's got eight. Hits a second. Up to 9 points on the game. G-Men look to go quick and maybe get a set in. Summer takes it hard to the hole. Very impressive there. Good, a quick first step, and he's up to 14. Ref from the complete other side of the court sees a foul. That'll be on 21 Evan Janik. That's his third already, and his team's third. Looks like Leo Grandizio and Max May are in for Janik and Vinny Grandizio. Gingrich to inbound to Warder. Good three-point look there by number 5, Luke Underwood. He hits, he's got 9. For those of you not keeping track, that's his third three-pointer. All of his points have been off of threes. Possibly a travel, but ref says no. And number 33 for the G-Man, Carter Bates, fouled by Corbin Osborne on that rebound. That'll be Osborne's first, team's first of the third, or of the third quarter and of the second half. Just over midway through the third quarter, Summer with a little, it's always an awkward shot for players, a little mid-range jump shot. Do they shoot a layup or do they shoot a jump shot? Summer decided to shoot a jump shot and missed. Warder for three, and Warder makes it. He's got 10 and 5 already in this quarter. Wide open three for Leo Grandizio, misses. May challenges a rebound but can't get it. Tigers got numbers ahead, out to Warder. Very impressive there, Warder on the layup. I'll give him two more, and he'll be shooting two. We have foul on Leo Grandizio, his first, team's fourth. Warder to shoot. One. He hits. He's up to 8 in this quarter alone, 15 in the game. So he's got half of his team's 30. May for 3. Lysak, a good offensive rebound, having trouble handling it. Shoots a fadeaway, misses everything. Grandizio couldn't handle it. Maybe knocked out by a Tiger, but ref says no. Lysak will come off, and Jukic will, number 40, Vince Jukic will come on. Bad pass there by Warder. G-Men to inbound, side out. Trying to set up a play here. get something to go and regain that momentum they had when they had about a 12-point lead, and now their lead's up to three, down to three, I should say. Leo Granizzi off the screen to Summer. Summer, easy three there. He's got five this quarter, 17 in the game. Kick ball there by number 22, Summer. Tigers have had 11 points this quarter, eight of them from the man with the ball right now, number 11, Matt Warder. Tigers looking to move the ball. Bad pass there by Gingrich. Underwood to come back on for the Tigers. Also in for the Tigers is Harrison Koblenz. Summer looking for a pass. May pump wisely passes up on a three. Would have been a hard shot. Got Summer in the paint. Summer looks to go up. Grandizio to shoot. Well, folks, sometimes you'd rather be lucky than good. Good bank there. Oh, good move by Warder. Warder, pull up Jay. No. Leo Grandizio up to five on the game. Bad pass there by Summer for the G-men. Tigers to inbound, looking to break that press. Good crossover by Underwood. Good push body check there by Grandizio, but didn't get away with it. They're putting in Elijah Hatfield and taking off Jackson Summer with a 9-point lead with 53 seconds left in the third quarter. Tigers to inbound. G-men are in a little bit of a zone here. New look for them this game. Oh, good Euro step by May, couldn't hit. Foul on Tigers number 12. Gingrich, number 34 for the G-men. Elijah Hatfield to shoot two. He's got his first point of the game. And for the Tigers is 21, Shelton. Brock Shelton. Out for the Tigers is number 12, Chase Gingrich. G-men lead by 10, 40-30 with 28 seconds left. Now they lead by 11 with Hatfield getting his second free throw and his second point of the game. Good steal by Grandizio. Has May. Good floater there by May. He's up to 10. Warder in open court. A little bit of a collision there on the layup. Maybe could have been a charge, but ref says no. Foul on Elijah Hatfield. That's his first. That's the team's sixth already. Warder at the line trying to cut into the G-men's 13-point lead. Can't hit on that free throw. See if he can hit on this one. He cannot. Jukic couldn't hold the ball. It's tied up with Corbin Osborne, but the G-men retain possession on the jump ball. Grandizio with a near half court heave at the end of the third quarter, doesn't fall. G-men lead 43-30, end of the third quarter. We'll be back. We're back to start the fourth quarter. The G-men holding a 43-30 lead. Quick stat check. Jackson Summer for the G-men with 17. May for the G-men with 10. Warder for the Tigers with... That appears to be... 15. Norman back into the game for the Tigers. He'll run the point. Didn't play at all in that third quarter. Maybe getting a break to have one final push. Good cross-court pass to Norman himself. And can't hit, but follows a shot. Fake spins. Pump fake. Tigers looking for something here. Maybe a catch and shoot three. No. Mishandles the pass. There's a catch and shoot three. That is good. Underwood up to 9 for the Tigers. Cuts into that 13-point lead and makes it 10. Ref calls a travel on Carter Bates. Summer in for the G-men for Jukic. Coach Peterson urges the G-men to press, and they do. Tigers able to break it. A little bit of a double dribble there by Shelton. Missed three by Summer. Rebound Gingrich. Tigers look to press. Push, I should say. Summer goes in hard, but can't hold on to it. Tigers inbound, out to Norman, doing most of the ball handling now that he's back in instead of taking that off of Warden's plate there. Finds the back of the rim, and finds the back of the net. He's got 4. Sometimes speed is all you need, and that's what Summer did there. Just faster than everybody. Couldn't cut him off. Norman's been snapping those passes all day. Out to Gingrich, rebound out to Warder, who drains the three-pointer. 45-38 G-men. We're back after that timeout. Team's looking to say, coach saying one final word to his players before the rest of the fourth quarter get started. G-men with number 5 Maxim May, 21 Evan Janik, 14 Colin Isaac, 33 Carter Bates, and 22 Jackson Summer. Summer's up to 19 in the game so far. Tigers with Norman, Shelton. Bates turns it over to Warder, and he's got 20. Foul on the floor, G-men to inbound. Also Osborne and Underwood on the floor for the Tigers. Maybe a bit of a miscommunication between ref and coach as the guy gets straightened out and the Tigers will inbound here. Finds a pass out to Norman. Deflected by Bates. Out to Warder. See what he can do here. Pass it to Underwood. Out to Norman. Offensive 3 seconds on Osborne. Second time the refs have called that. He'll be out and Gingrich will come in for him. G-men inbound, coming down. May has Bates deep. And Bates has the bucket. Most teams won't give up that long ball, but maybe a little defensive error there that did. Isaac with the tip pass. Has players ahead of him, tries to do it all himself. Gets past one man, throws it right into Norman. Norman out to Warder. Liza can't get the chase down. Warder's up to 22. Looks like the Tigers call an apparent timeout with that 5-point disadvantage of 47-42 here with 4 minutes 17 seconds left in the fourth. We'll be back. All right, well, we are back after that timeout. The G-men to inbound going down. Summer with 19 for the G-men. Warder with 22 for the Tigers. May with 10 for the G-men and Underwood with... Summer can't hit the three. Tie up between Shelton and Janik. That'll be a jump ball. G-men retain possession. Lysak to inbound. Let's see what the play the G-men come up with here. Warder up ahead. Gets absolutely swatted by number 14, Colin Lysak. G-men back in transition. Janik with the ball. Coach says slow it down, so he does. May good hustle to get it back, but Warder picks it up. Norman with the rebound. Foul on number 21, Evan Janik. Maybe thinks he can get away with some things that he wouldn't have before. He's up to 4 fouls. That'll be his team's 8th, so that means Norman will be shooting a 1-1. For those of you that don't know, if he makes the first one, then he gets to shoot a second one. But if he misses the first one, then anybody can rebound it. And he does make the first one. He's up to three. Had the ball a lot, but only 3 points to show for it. He's been doing having some good passes and ball handling skills, so that's how he can contribute. Liza could pass to Bates. Bates out ahead, easy layup. Goes across to that preferred left side for two. He's got eight. Swatted away by Lysak from that pass into the post. Norman trying to make something happen. Warder says, give me the ball. Norman says, give me the ball. Spin move. Too many steps there. But he missed a shot anyway. So G-men ball with a 49-44 lead. Very rare call there, a warning on 21 blue for reaching over the line. Ref says stay back a little bit, so he does. Oh, good pass there by Jukic. Liza got ahead. Liza goes up hard with a layup for two. He's got four. G-men lead 51-44 with about just under 3 minutes left in this fourth quarter. Good defense there. Jukic out, Hatfield in for the G-men. That looks like Osborne in, Shelton out for the Tigers. Hatfield inbound for the G-men. Ref calls a offensive foul on Hatfield, Elijah Hatfield to be specific. After a quick statistical fix, Tigers have the ball going against that G-men zone. Norman passes up a three for a Warner wide open three-pointer. That'll be a foul on Gingrich. His third, team's third, maybe team's fourth. Ain't that team's fourth. G-men 51, Tigers 44 with 2 minutes and 14 seconds left in the fourth. Tigers breaking out a full court press here to Isaac for two. He's up to six, four on the fourth. Warder for two. He's up to 24. Coach Peterson for the G-men calls timeout as they lead 53-46 with a minute and 52 seconds left. So far this game has been a little high scoring for a JV game, but happens once in a while. Good offense by both teams. Very quick pace by both teams as well, trying to push the ball and get out and run in transition. We'll be back. We're back as both teams take the floor. Bates, Lysak, Leo Grandizio, Summer, and May for the G-men. Norman, Underwood, Warder, Gingrich, and Osborne for the Tigers. May with the ball in the middle of the court, pass it out to Summer. G-men trying to slow the ball down. No need to risk a turnover here with a 6-point lead and 1:40 left in the game. They almost had a turnover, but Summer picks it up. Out to Leo Grandizio, out to Bates, out to May. They have a lot of motion there on the wing. May gets into the paint, but Coach Peterson yells, slow it down, and May slows it down. Running a 5-out set here, trying to just hold the ball, and no reason to risk any silly turnovers with 6-point lead and a minute to play. Running a lot of just running around, trying to get the ball, and there's a foul. Tigers knew they're going to start fouling sometime, and it'll be a foul on Norman. That's his second, team's fifth. And timeout. We'll be back. And we're back for the last 56.7 seconds of the fourth quarter. In this JV boys game between the host Garfield G-men and visiting Lake Turner Christian Tigers. G-men hold a 53-46 lead with, again, 56.7 seconds left. And they side it, inbound it to May. Bates with the layup. Bates, a little too hard. Liza can't handle it. Norman back in transition looking for a layup that he gets. He's up to 6-4 in the fourth. Ref says foul. Or maybe not. That'll be on Tigers 11, Matt Warder, who has 24 points in this game. Summer with 19 for the G-men. Another foul here on Norman. That'll be his third, team seventh, and May will shoot 1-1. May has a very quiet 10 here. Still has 10. Tigers with a 2-on-2 here. Good spin move by Norman. Little floater, that kid doesn't fall. Tigers knocked it away. G-men look to go quick here. Get the ball across, 19 seconds left. Tigers need to foul, and they do. Colin Lysak to shoot a 1-1. Misses the first, out to Summer. Summer wisely throws it out. Lysak to shoot a 1-1 again. Tigers up to 9 fouls, so one more foul and it'll be 2 shots. But We're at 15.8 seconds left, and the G-men are up 53-48. Lysak for the foul shot. Lysak makes it. He's got 7-5 in this quarter. 54-48, 15.8 seconds left. He's got 8. Norman pulls up for 3 off the front rim. Gingrich for 2. 5 seconds left. Tigers need a miracle. That they won't get. That's your final here. Quarter for the Tigers with 24. Summer for the G-men with 19. G-men win 55-50. We'll be back in about 20 minutes for the varsity game.
Okay, welcome to the varsity contest tonight for the live stream between Garfield and Lake Center. This game played about a week ago. I think it was last Saturday these two teams met, and it was a close game. I believe the Tigers were up 20-11 at halftime, and the G-men clamped down on defense, roared back in the second half, and were able to win 38-33. So we'll see if how this goes. For both teams, it was the second night of a back-to-back, so both teams should be a little fresher tonight, maybe more offense, maybe a little bit more up and down than it was the last game. Last time was a very difficult shooting night for both teams, and we'll see how they start off here. For the Tigers, they will start off with Jacob Jaber, a senior, Anson Graham, a senior, Ethan Bauer, a junior, Kobe Byler, a senior, and Patrick Miller, a senior. The G-men will counter with their usual starting lineup, Owen Janik, Tristan Gideon, both seniors, Anthony Demma, junior, Caden Spade, a junior, and Brody Swagonski, a junior. So we will see how these two teams match up. On paper, they match up very well against each other, very similar styles, very similar sizes. The G-men got the better of the Tigers in round one. So welcome to the stream. Welcome to our partner, going two mics again tonight. Cameron Edwards helping out tonight as well.
Hello, everyone. Interesting thing before the game is number 42, Patrick Miller for the Tigers. You know, big size. We'll see if he can, you know, try and do what Mason Williams did for the Cats on for the Wildcats on Tuesday against the G-men and wreck some havoc down there in the post. So,
yeah, Patrick Miller does pose a little inside threat. Great hands for the kid. Tip one quickly by Janik down to Gideon. Gideon quickly for two. So Gideon gets the G-men on the board within the first 10 seconds of the game. Tough man-to-man defense here for the G-men, switching screens. Again, they have the ability to do that. Three on the way from Bauer, no good. Ripped down. Swagonski ends up with it after a little bit of a tussle, a little sloppiness there to Gideon. Gideon again will drive in. Nice kick out. Spade's got a great look at it. That one rims out. Rebound almost by Janik, but it's ripped down by Bauer. Bauer, nice drift pass there. Shuffled his feet there by Byler. So good closeout there by the G-men to cause the turnover. So, again, already a little better tempo than it was at the beginning of last week's game. So Swagonski will get the G-men triggered on offense, get a set called. To Janik. Janik kicks out to Gideon. Gideon with a clean look. Splash. So Gideon with a quick 5 points. I believe he was the high scorer at Lake Center last week as well. So
who passed that to him? Janik.
Byler again with the feet shuffle, but not called there. Miller. Again, Patrick will play inside and outside. So the G-men do have to step out on him. He isn't just a screen and roll type player, even though he can do both. Inside to Miller. Nice little turnaround off glass. Good. So a quick two there for Patrick Miller. And G-men up 5-2. Again, lots of movement for both teams. And if the defense overplays, G-men will cut back door. If they underplay, they'll just pop right back out. So a lot of read and react here, like Gideon just did right there. There goes Swagonski on the curl cut. And good ball movement. Good defense by the Tigers here, making the G-men work. Gideon will get into the lane, kick it back out. Again, good possession defensively, good offensive possession here with good ball movement. Swagonski baseline drive, move around Miller, no good. Tipped out to Janik, who gets a clean look. And that is a little long, but another offensive board there for Demas. That's two on this possession. Keep it alive. Demas going to get a clean look at three, and Demas three rims out. And another offensive rebound by the G-men. And a foul. This one, I believe, is going to be on number three, Anson Graham. No, it is not. It's going to be on Patrick Miller. So that is his first substitution of the night. Geddes coming in for Janik.
Yeah, the Tigers with that big body down low, but let the G-men get three offensive rebounds in that possession.
Spade with a clean look, and it doesn't. Got another offensive board there, this one by Geddes, and this one rims out. So G-men probably had about five offensive rebounds, extra possessions there, unable to come away with any points. Tigers getting their offense set. Good defense and a travel. So Bauer with the turnover there for the Tigers. So good, solid defense. They wanted a set. And, again, these two teams just played a week ago. So, again, they're probably pretty familiar with the sets that each of them run. Geddes thought better of that. And Garfield has run a lot more of this flex action this year. Rebound to Miller. Quickly down the floor comes Graham. Graham with the pull-up that's blocked. Sogonski tries to sell it, tries to save it, but it will stay with the Tigers. So again, G-men running have added the flex look to their offense, trying to give teams some different matchups. Tigers inbound it to Beiler. Beiler will take it. Nice little scoop there for Beiler. Rebound to Sogonski, quickly down the floor. Picked up by Bauer. Beiler guarding Spade here. And back to that open motion offense that the G-men have been running. Again, it's a read and react offense. Sogonski hit two of those the other night. Geddes with a clean look. And that one back rims no good. But nice deflection there by Dema to save it to Geddes. Geddes with the great idea, but just the wrong pass. Another substitution for the G-men, Janik. Janik coming in for Dema. So again, it looks like the G-men are going about every 2 to 3 minutes with a substitution here. Tigers have yet to make a substitution.
Yeah, again, both teams going to play maybe seven guys at the most. Tigers look like they're going to play about six. So be like repeat of Tuesday's game. With
yeah,
Parker.
Not a lot of depth here, so just right. Trying to. I do not believe. And a nice drive there. And offensive rebound and one for Ethan Bauer. So good put back there by Bauer. Neither team goes very deep against the G-men. Are six. Sometimes we'll go to that seventh man. Tigers have nobody with a warm-up off, so they're rolling with six right now. So Bauer will try to complete the three-point play, and he does. So after a quick start by the G-men, the Tigers have roared back and have answered every basket, and we're tied at five. So again, this is the first game kind of went this way too. Very low scoring, very methodical. Both teams sit down and play solid defense, not really given a lot of open looks. So you got to work, but which is going to, and I can't leave Gideon open. And Tristan almost makes him pay there. Back rim, rebound to Jaber. And Bauer quickly down the floor to Beiler. Beiler with a jump stop, no call there. Back to Bauer for three. So Ethan Bauer has come alive for the Tigers here with a quick 6 points. And they're challenging Miller by Gideon. Good rip down. There's got to be something there. And we're going with a jump ball, and that's going to go to the Tigers. And you got Dema coming back into the game, this time for Gideon. So three of the starters have gotten a little quick break there for the G-men. The Tigers have yet to make one substitution. The Tigers are up 8-5. After a quick 5-0 burst, mainly by Gideon. Miller had a flash look there, and they just missed it. Bauer to Beiler. Beiler almost traveled there. Good defense by Janik to Jaber. Jaber gets in the lane. Back to Bauer. No good. Rebound by Janik. Janik quickly down the floor. He's got Geddes if he looks to him, but he tries to cross over. Almost gets it stolen away, and Tigers are able to set their defense. So here we go. We're going to go with an ISO here into that flex. There's Janik. Again, not necessarily looking for that layup, but they're also looking for that pin down for a three-point shot or possibly a layup. Spade with a quick three from the top, and that's good.
Yep, ties it up at eight. Already less than 2 minutes to play. Scores only 8-8. So.
Yeah, not a lot of possessions so far. And their blown defensive assignment. Wild shot there by Jaber. Rebound back. Here comes Miller to back to Jaber. Jaber to Bauer. Bauer setting the stage here. Back to Jaber. Jaber seems like he's been at LCC for a long time. Anson Graham with the ball. Graham kicks it out to Bauer with another clean look, and that's splash. A good three there for Bauer. He's answered. So Bauer's got the hot hand. He's got 9 of the Tigers' 11. The G-men quickly down the floor, and it falls for Spade. Good power layup there by Spade. Getting the foul. This one will be on Anson Graham. His first, team second. Spade with the chance to tie this game up. Spade's free throw is up and good. We are tied at 11 with a minute to go here in the first quarter. Fast moving first quarter, not a lot of possessions. Very back and forth. Jaber with the look, back to Bauer. Bauer's got the hot hand for the Tigers. No, I don't think, good take there. Nice dish down to Miller, waited for the defense. Good power layup there by Miller. Good dish and drive by Jaber. G-men will have a chance to take the last shot if they want. As we approach under 30 seconds to go here in the quarter. Pin down for Spade. Spade with a clean look at three. Back rim, no good. Rebound to Geddes. Geddes throws it to Bauer, and here comes the Tigers with a chance to take the last shot. Step through to Jaber. Jaber to Miller with 10 seconds to go. Miller with the spin, fading. Nice soft rim there by the big man. G-men quickly down the floor. 4, 3, 2. Spade at the buzzer and the foul. That's probably going to be on Miller. If so, that's his second. That's a big, big call there. If not, they're going to call it on Graham. They're going to call it on Graham. That's either way, it was their second foul. So Graham picks up his second. It kind of, I think for the Tigers, it's better that it's Graham than Miller, but we'll see how that pulls out. So Spade's got 2-shot foul here with no time on the clock. Chance to pull the G-men back within 2. First free throw is splash. Second free throw, and also splash. So we will end the first quarter with those 2 free throws. The G-men trail 15-13 after darting out to a 5-0 lead in the first 30 seconds. So we'll be back in 30 seconds. Hey, we're back to start the second quarter. G-men trail 15-13 to Lake Center Christian Tigers. They will start off with the ball here. Again, G-men got off to a very quick 5-0 start with behind Tristan Gideon. Spade got hot after that, but Ethan Bauer was in the middle. Nice backdoor look. Great look there. Good backdoor look there to Janik for that layup. Nice look to Miller. Ball goes right through his hand.
Did they just run cover? No, that's how Janik got his layup. Did they just run cutter?
Got a demo with the ball here to get things going for the G-men.
And good
Spade
look.
Fakes a three into Gideon for two. Yeah.
So right now it looks like, and he stepped in, so that's a turnover. Stepped in on the inbounds pass at the timeout. Tanner Norman checked in for Lake Center. Their first sub because Graham has picked up his foul. So G-men have come out real quick here in the first 30 seconds to take 2-point lead into Spade. Spade pump fakes, leaves it short, and that would be, they're either going to, they're going to give that to the Tigers. They probably could have called a foul on that, but instead they're going to give it to the Tigers. So Ethan Bauer will bring the ball up and get the Tigers set.
Again, try to slow down here, maybe get a good look here. Not trying to rush it.
Yeah, similar offense, both read and react offenses. The defense undercuts it. They're going to just pop back. If the defense overplays it, they're going to cut back door. So it's just a simple read and react here on part of the offense. Takes some time, takes advantage of that aggressiveness. If the defense wants to be aggressive, you could get some mismatches. Beiler for three. It hits the rim, no good. Rebound by
Vinny
D'Angrisio. Thank you. I had to search real quick for number 20. Demma will pull one. Back rim, no good. Rebound by Beiler. Probably not the shot that they want Demma taken, but if he's got open, he does have the ability to make it. Bauer will rim that out as well, and Demma will secure the rebound. Quickly to Spade. Spade's going to look to drive back to Demma. Demma, nice pump fake in the lane. No good. Rebound to Beiler, and he almost lost control. Good smart move there by the senior. Again, coach asking the team slow down a little bit. They don't want to get into a track meet with the G-men. Again, they definitely don't have the depth. G-men go six deep, seven deep at times, but apparently Lake Center only goes five. So that's the missed a look there because coach was kind of upset. Out of the corner of my eye, I could see him looking for something. Good take there. We got a foul before the charge. So hard take there by Bauer. We've got Janik with his first foul. Calling hands, so that should not be shooting. Should be on the floor. Nope, they're going to call shooting on that. So where he called the foul probably should have been an on-the-floor foul. And first free throw for Bauer is good. Checking in for the G-men. Brody Swagonski and Eric Geddes coming in, and Vinny Grandizio and Caden Spade have checked out.
Yeah, Ethan Bauer for the Tigers already up to 10 quick points. So.
And his next free throw dances just off. G-men quickly down the floor to Geddes. Geddes high off the glass and it rims out, but he's going to stick with it. Doesn't get the rebound, and here comes Jaber quickly down the floor to Norman. Norman sliding to Miller. Miller with the little shot that airballs to Gideon. Swagonski back to Geddes. Geddes is going to pop another one, and he's going to get fouled in the act. So this one's going to be on Miller because he's talking to the ref would be my guess, and it is. So the Tigers are in a little bit of trouble here. Two of their starters sitting with two fouls, Miller with two and Graham with two, and Geddes will go to the line for a two-shot foul. First one by Eric is back rim, no good. Second free throw, front rim, no good. So he overcompensated there. Rebound by Beiler, who's trapped, and they're going to get a reach either on Gideon or Janik. They're going to call Janik, and that's Janik's second. So Janik with two. Janik got in foul trouble against Mogador as well, and it kind of hurt him in the long run. They got to bring Spade back into the game. So Janik didn't get a ton of time on Tuesday as well because he picked up some early fouls.
Yeah, Ethan Bauer really taking charge here. The Tigers offense trying to do as much as he can.
Bauer's been the most aggressive of the Tigers by far. Miller has been the next aggressive one. Nobody else has really taken a lot of shots. I don't think Jaber's really taken a shot. Good take by Swagonski, but no touch around the rim. Here comes Beiler quickly down the floor. G-men do a good job to cover it up. Bauer's going to step right into that three, though. That's not what you want him to do. And three more for Ethan Bauer. And that lead, that gives the Tigers the lead back at 19-17. A lot of curl cuts around that high ball screen. Good slip there by Swagonski. He's got Dema. Dema will think about it. Dema will pull it. No good. And Swagonski with the good offensive rebound. And no, that one won't go either.
Another offensive rebound.
And Swagonski with another offensive rebound.
Swagonski already up to five rebounds about midway through the second quarter. So
G-men have done a tremendous job on the offensive boards, just haven't been able to get the putbacks. Bauer being guarded by Dema down here. Look to pull up over to Jaber. Jaber will get into the lane and throw something up. No good. Ripped down by Spade. Spade's got people open if he gets his head up. Can't get the ball under control. Throws it to Geddes in the corner, and Geddes almost loses it to Swagonski. Around to Spade. Back to Geddes. Swagonski, again, hit two of them the other night, so he will shoot and make those. Good defense by Jaber on Gideon, making him take it inside. And we got another foul here. This one, I'm guessing, by Beiler. Nope, they're going to call it on Jaber in his hands. So that is the fifth team foul here by the Tigers. And Gideon, after a hot start, has had a quiet 8 minutes since. Tristan's first free throw, good. Second free throw, also good. So G-men back up by two. As we go under 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Back and forth game. Similar style to the last time. Nice back door by Beiler. Looks down to Miller. Again, Miller's got great touch around the rim. That's two more for the big man. He's up to eight. So really, him and Ethan Bauer have all of the Tigers' points and really have taken about all of the Tigers' shots. Another drive by Gideon, and we're going to have a travel there. So Tigers have been a two-man team. Substitution coming in for the Tigers. Norman checking out, and number two, that is Matt Warder, a freshman checking in for the Tigers. So one freshman out, another freshman in. So now we know why the Tigers aren't going very deep on the bench, because they're bringing freshmen in. Beiler with the ball. Nice ball hand, nice movement. And he's going to somehow keep control. And Kobe Beiler with 2 points. And Lake Center back up by two. Spade hiding behind the screen. Up to Geddes over here. Comes Swagonski over, back over to Spade. Again, Spade will think about it. Drive baseline. Back out to Gideon. Gideon's going to drive, and he's going to miss. But Dema's there to clean it up, and that's two for Dema. So Dema's probably going to have, what, 4 rebounds as well, somewhere in that neighborhood? So Dema and Swagonski, between the two of them, almost have 10 rebounds. I cannot let Ethan Bauer come down and just walk right into a shot. G-men quickly down the field, quickly down the court. Swagonski, got my sport wrong there. Used to Swagonski running the ball down the football field. Forces up a shot, and here comes Bauer again. G-men do a little better job this time of stepping up on him. Almost give up the back door, but good job by Swagonski. Good hands there. Brody down the floor to Demma. Demma into the lane. Good jump stop. And two more for Anthony Demma.
Little change of pace here in the end of the, towards the end of the
Yeah, we got a little bit more up and down here in the last 2 minutes. But you can tell that the Tigers definitely do not want to run with the G-men because of the depth. Bauer guarded by Spade. Over to the freshman Warder. Back out to Byler. Byler to Jaber. Jaber back to Bauer. Bauer guarded by the freshman Geddes. And Bauer into the lane. Byler deep three. That's hard rim, and somehow that one falls. So kind rim on the road has put the Tigers up four with 30 seconds to go. G-men are going to try to take the last shot here. They're going to try to get one here. Here we go with we're going to get an ISO. Trying to get an ISO here for between Spade and Gideon. Back out to Gideon. Deep three, no good. Patrick Miller tracks that rebound down and will give it to Ethan Bauer, who's going to take care of the ball. And I expect the Tigers to take the last shot of the half here. Walking with a four-point lead. Under 10 seconds to go. Bauer one-on-one to the freshman. Freshman's going to hoist one up, and that's not going to be, A, the shot they wanted, but, B, good defense by the G-men. So not the quarter, the end of the quarter that Coach Oleski probably wanted to see, but we are now going to take a little break here for half. The Tigers are up 29-25. All right, welcome back for the second half. Hopefully we got our technical issue with the scoreboard figured out. Appreciate those from home who have let us know. Again, we can see things on our end, but we can't always see what you can see, so we appreciate that. First half, really dominated by neither team. It was back and forth, back and forth. But I would say the last 2 minutes was probably dominated by the Tigers, who were able to stretch their lead to what we currently sit at, 29-25. Gideon started off with the hot hand for the G-men, scoring the first 5 points in about the first 30 seconds. And then it was the Ethan Bauer show. Ethan Bauer really took over from a scoring standpoint, scoring 16 of the Lake Center Tigers' 29 points, hitting 4 threes and really causing some havoc there. We'll see what Coach Oleski's adjustment is, if he goes to a double team, a face guard, or what he's going to do. He's going to put Janik on him to start off here. Janik, though, handcuffed with 2 fouls. Tigers in a little foul trouble as well. Anson Graham there as you, with the ball. He has 2, and Patrick Miller has 2. So we'll quickly go inside and foul there by Demma. So LCC's adjustment was to get the big man some touches. It looks like the coaching staff is trying to tell Owen to be face guarding Bauer. So Patrick Miller's first free throw is good.
Yeah, Brody Stoganski with 5 I have him down for 5 rebounds, and I bet all those were offensive rebounds.
Hey, so between him and Demma, they've been cleaning the glass. Both free throws there good for Miller, and LCC extends their lead 31-25 here to start the second half. Both Patrick Miller and Ethan Bauer in double figures for the Tigers. Nice backdoor cut there. Recovery by the Tigers. Good closeouts. Again, both teams very solid fundamentally defensively. Good closeouts, running the opponent off the line. Swagonski left open for 3. He hit those the other night, and Gideon tries to back tap it, and that taps it right to Terry Peterson, who's unfortunately not playing tonight. So Tigers will inbound the ball, and Janik close on Bauer. Getting it across, trying to disrupt what the Tigers are doing. Janik right up in his face, causes the turnover. And here's Janik, the reward for 2. So good play there by Owen Janik, causing the turnover into 2 for the G-men. Jaber tries to drive inside, and that ball is kicked away by the G-men. So good defensive stand there with another opportunity here to cut into the Tiger lead.
Yeah, try and get a shot here to get it back to a one possession game.
Guessing they're going to try to get Spade open for a shot here. And there it is. Got Gideon posted up. Demma. Again, Demma's taken 2 of those, hasn't made 1, so he's probably going to think better of shooting that. There's Spade will pull it, though, and Spade with a splash. Spade hits his 2nd 3 of the night, and it's a 1-point game. Again, Bauer with pressure and a push there by Swagonski. So defensive intensity has picked up for the G-men. The physicalness has also picked up. Looks like it's going to be a substitution here. Geddes coming in for Janik. So we'll see if Geddes gets the assignment of guarding Bauer or if they're going to trade it off to Swagonski. Deep to Miller. Here comes the flex cut. Nice cut by kick back out. And Beiler, deep 3, Brick City. Miller with a rebound and another rebound and another rebound and no good. 3 chances there for Miller. Spade quickly down the floor and the G-men are back up. So the G-men have come alive here in this third quarter as they did a week ago down in Hartville. And Jaber all the way to the basket. Contact there by Demma. So late whistle, but There was some contact there. That's Demma's second. Again, neither team is very deep, so any of these fouls are going to add up. So now you're sitting with Janik with two and Demma with two. On the side of the Tigers, you've got Anson Graham with two and Patrick Miller with two. So we'll see what happens here. Jacob Jaber attempting his first points of the night. No good. Substitution for the G-men. Owen Janik back in, probably for Demma for the fouls. He is getting Demma. So guessing Janik will go back to guarding Bauer. We don't really know who was going to be guarding him when Janik was out. Jaber's second free throw is true. And we are tied. So let's see what offensive set the G-men come up with here. Going to look to Gideon, get posted up. Screen and roll. Gideon's going to pop. Nope, Gideon's going to roll. Stolen away by Bauer. Mr. Do-Everything tonight for the Tigers. Quickly to Jaber. Jaber jump stop. Kicks it to Miller. Good recovery there by the G-men. Good defense by Geddes. And Janik is back on Bauer. Again, if this ISO is going to happen, they're going to have to get Bauer some screens. Not going to be able to do it all himself. Jaber to Beiler. Beiler kicks back out. Jaber, good. So that free throw must have been all Jacob needed to get going. He's got four quick points. And again, quickly down to Janik, to Swagonski, jump stop in the lane, back rim, no good. Rebound by Jaber. Saying the name a lot tonight. He's got William. He's got Anson Graham outside, and he's going to kick it to Beiler for three, no good. Rebound, Jaber. Jaber in traffic. He got to do something with it, and he's scoring two more points.
Yeah.
Jacob Jaber has come alive here in the second half after being pretty much a non-factor in the first half.
Yeah, he's the smallest guy on the court.
He is the smallest guy on the floor, absolutely.
But he's playing like he's the biggest right now.
Janik will eye up a three and answer that. So now we're getting some offense. Now we're getting some action back and forth for both teams. The Tigers have a two-point lead. Bauer quickly in the lane, and he's going to be tied up. Oh, they're going to call traveling.
Demma back in for Swagonski here.
It's an interesting call there.
Yeah,
I would have gone more of a jump ball there, which would have given it to the G-men. And either way, the G-men were getting it, whether it be a jump ball or the travel. So G-men a chance here to take the lead with a three or tie with a two. Back to that flex look, quickly into Spade. Spade couldn't handle the pass. Again, here come the Tigers. Again, Janik sticking close to Bauer, making him work. And that's what you want to do, tire him out, take those legs away so those long shots won't be as easy. Patrick Miller with the roll. Again, it handles the ball well for a big man. Plays almost like a guard and a big body. Has nice hesitation there, nice floater. Ethan Bauer with two, first two of the second half. Again, probably one of the best pure basketball players I've been able to see this year in our homestand. Gideon's three just rims out. That rim was favorable to the Tigers in the first half, but unkind to the G-men there on that trip. But the ball stays with the G-men. Another substitution. Vinny Grandizio back in for Janik. And inbound back to Demma. Geddes with the ball. Again, this will be interesting. You're going to see, ask Spade and Gideon to do a lot of the scoring right now. Demma's going to say, I've got a chance at this, and rebound by Anson Graham. Quickly down the floor. And nobody's going to guard Bauer. That's probably not a good idea. Splash. Well, somebody better guard him, or this is going to get ugly because he's up to 21 points, and the Tigers have extended their lead to 7. So Owen Janik was on him. Now Owen Janik checked out, and nobody seemed to check back in for guarding Bauer. Spade's going to try to pull, and he's going to answer. And Spade's going to get – oh, they're going to call a timeout here. Thought Spade was going to get something for woofing there right in front of the ref. But Spade is up to 16 points, I believe.
Yeah, Bauer with 21, half of his team's 42, so he's really carrying the load right now.
Yes, the G-men are going to have to do something, whether they run a second defender at him or something to get the ball out of his hands, but you definitely – that's two different instances where they've let him just walk the ball right up the floor and walk right into a three. Definitely one of the best pure shooters that the G-men will play the entire year. Probably comparable to the guard that they played very early in the season at McDonald. That is another guard that played very similar to Bauer. So, yeah, the Tigers don't go deep, so if the G-men can start banging the ball inside, they can get the Tigers in some foul trouble. G-men are going to try to switch up here, and they're going to try Swagonski guarding Bauer. So we'll see what happens here. So Jaber is going to get this ball, and then we're playing on the wrong side. So here comes Bauer down the floor, guarded by Swagonski. Again, probably be a good idea to get a screen for him. Other than that, he's just going to be dribbling all over the place. So there is a foul on Swagonski. This is the only problem with that. That's Brody's second. So let's see what the Tigers have here. Nice little out-of-bounds set. Into Patrick Miller. He's just going to back down whoever, and he's got to. So you can't let the big man just back him down. And again, six-point lead, and Miller is up to 12 points. But Gideon's been quiet, which means he's due to score. And then there's Jaber with the play, the hustle play there, and the turnover. He rolled over on the ball. It's a great hustle play there. And right now, that's kind of the difference in this ball game, is the Tigers now are getting the 50-50 balls that the G-men were able to get in the first half. Janik checks back into this game. Again, probably going to guard Bauer. Again, as I said before, Gideon has been very quiet here. I'm just waiting for him. Had him at the top of the key and missed him. Janik will launch a three, though, and that will rim out. No good. Rebound to Anson Graham, who's going to throw it to Miller, and he's going to tip it to Gideon. Gideon's going to go, and he is going to get fouled in the set there. I thought for a second they were going to call the elbow that came up, but good for Tristan, they didn't. That is Anson Graham's third foul, unfortunately, though. So looks like
he might have to take a break pretty soon here, but coaches say no, not yet at least.
Yeah.
Might have to play a little bit more cautiously.
So Tristan, again, Tristan's a rhythm shooter, and he's not getting his shots up. This is where he's going to struggle. Hopefully these free throws can break him out of this little scoring slump. Again, he had three baskets early, and he's been very quiet since. And both free throws are missed there. So, again, needs to get some more touches, needs to get some more looks. Quickly down the floor, Byler, Jaber, he's hit one, and that one is no good. Miller, and we're going, staying here. And here comes the substitution. So Patrick Miller subbed out, and Tanner Norman coming in, a freshman. So again, both LCC's freshmen have seen action here. Both their substitution have been freshmen. Good screen action there by the Tigers to get an open look there. I like the movement there. Jaber quickly outside to the freshman, to Norman. Back to Byler. Byler bringing the defense out, and that ball is tipped away by Spade.
Yeah, Tigers maybe going a little small here, get some motion going.
Well, with a minute 18 to go, I'm sure they're trying to hang on to the lead and try to get a little bit of rest for somebody, mainly Ethan Bauer, but doesn't look like he's tired. A lot of dribbling. Again, Tigers looks like they're trying to take the air out of the ball a little bit. If I'm the G-man, I'm probably going to leave Norman, except that he's going to do that. So nice little finger roll by Tanner Norman. Not somebody that's going to show up in the scouting report for the G-men. Nice pump fake by Spade. Hard take. Back rim, no good. So that foul is going to be on Jacob Jaber. That is Jacob's second foul. So Spade is going to be shooting two shots here. Again, LCC coach has to be very happy. Coach Bright, in that he has gotten contributions out of people like Jacob Jaber, like Tanner Norman, coming in off the bench.
Yeah, Spade up to 17 now.
This half has been mainly Spade scoring. Janik has 5 in the quarter, but it's been Spade. Spade's got 9 in the quarter. And all the way, rimmed out. Here comes Spade down the floor, under a minute to go. G-men are going to get set, going to cut into this lead. 6-point lead for the Tigers. So again, content to move the ball around, get the shot that they want, possibly taking the last shot. Looks like they're going to be trying to take the last shot of the quarter. Spade whips it around to Swagonski. Back out to Spade, who's eyeing it up. 15 seconds to go. Good screen there. Take all the way to Spade. And we got a charge there on Spade. Again, Jaber was set on that. Probably went too early with 10 seconds to go. That's not the call you it's not the take you want with that much time to go. So G-men, see what they do here. Gonna let Bauer walk the ball up. Going to set a high screen for him. He's going to pull it. I don't see him passing it. He's going to pull it from the volleyball line, short. And Jaber, no. Again, good take there. He knew that he was taking that as the last shot. G-men trail going into the fourth quarter. Need to buckle up on defense, shut down Ethan Bauer, and definitely limit the touches of Patrick Miller. That's been the difference here. So down 46-40, entering the fourth quarter. We'll be back in 30 seconds. All right, we're back here to start off the fourth and final stanza. G-men trail 46-40 to the Lake Center Christian Tigers. So far for Lake Center, it's been the Ethan Bauer show with 21 points. And Spade has almost answered that with 18 for the G-men, but nobody else for the G-men are in double figures. Tristan Gideon sitting with 9 for LCC. Patrick Miller does have double figures for the Tigers at 12 points, I believe. Yes, 12 points. So let's see what the G-men look is here that they get. Jaber with that very big pressure defense there on Swagonski. Demma being guarded by Miller. Here goes Gideon to the lane and 2. That's the Gideon that we need. Tristan can do that almost any possession he wants. G-men down 4 now to the Tigers. Again, Tigers are not running screens for Bauer. Kid's getting open on his own. Miller is also getting open on his own. Getting his own rebound, no good. And he fouled there, but they didn't call it. Quickly down the floor. And here's one. And there's the foul that we were looking for. So Miller's 3rd. Demma can't convert that one. 2 opportunities there for Miller down at the other end. missed both putbacks. Puts Anthony Demma at the line. So Anthony with the two-shot foul here. First free throw, short. No legs on that one. Second free throw coming for Demma. Back rim, so he overcompensated. Rebound there by Beiler. Over to Bauer. Bauer, step back three, rims out, and that ball is going to stay with the Tigers. So Bauer tried to step back and didn't quite have it, but maybe the legs are starting to go a little bit. He is having to work really hard on offense to get his shot. Good suffocating defense there by Swagonski. Again, not running screens for him, making him do a lot of the stuff on his own. It would be helpful if they could run a screen for him. And he's going to get a five count here. Nope, we got another foul on Swagonski. A little bit of a bailout there. Had darn close to a five-second count. That's Brody's third. So next foul, the Tigers will be shooting the rest of the game. The Tigers have only committed three on their half. So good look into Graham. Graham back to Bauer. Bauer had the look, tried to throw it through people, and the G-men throw it right back. So back-to-back turnovers there. In a game like this, that's not what you want. So Janik back in. He's going to be guarding Bauer. Swagonski was guarding Bauer. Again, letting him walk the ball up the floor is not really what you want to do, because you want to pressure him and make him work the full 84 feet. Beiler all the way to the rim. Back rim no good. And that one is going to the G-men. So Tigers are 0 for this quarter. I believe 0 for 4. All layups for the most part, except for that deep three by Bauer. So maybe 0 for 5 this quarter. So maybe the legs are starting to go a little bit. So we're going to look here for Spade or Gideon. And there's a foul there by Jaber. And that'll be Jacob's third. It's only the team fourth. But again, both teams are really up in you defensively, making you work. There's Spade's got a look. Spade over to Demma. Demma will take it to the rim on Miller. Good power there by Demma. So again, the G-men have not been stopped when they go to the rim. They just need to do it more often and not settle for the outside shots. So two-point game, 46-44. 5.5 minutes to go here. Good pick and roll. Good steal by Demma. Demma down the floor. Good pass to Gideon, who bobbles it in. We're tied. We got a timeout by the Tigers. So Gideon up to 13 after that steal and score. Looks like we're going full timeout here by the Tigers. So 46-46, roughly five and a half minutes to go. We'll be back in 30. All right, back after that timeout. G-men have stormed back to tie this game at 46. Again, LCC has yet to score this quarter. So G-men have won this quarter 6-0 so far. There's the double. And the Tigers are going to either have to burn a timeout or, nope, there they go quickly down the floor to Miller. Miller with the pump fake, up and good. So that's good answer by LCC coming out of the timeout. G-men quickly down the floor to Janik. Janik gets Spade. Spade over to Gideon. Gideon on Bauer. I would drive on him, but that's me. Demma will take a look, and that one rims out, short rim. And Bauer with another rebound. So again, when Bauer's guarding you, I would be driving on him. Nice floater there by Bauer. That kid's got the whole package. He's got the whole repertoire of shots. He's got step backs. He's got floaters. The best pure basketball players I've seen in a while. Good pump fakes there by Spade to try to get Graham moving. Gideon, again, Gideon can drive. I have drive on Bauer. He has zero fouls. Make the kid work. Good step in by Gideon, and that ball is ripped down by Miller. Back to Jaber, again over to Bauer. Again, why are we letting him just walk the ball up the floor? Make him work. Make him work. There's a screen. Good switch there. Now Gideon's guarding him. And they're going to try that same look. Jaber is going to get a five-second call here. Good defense by Demma. Beiler has him trapped, and he stole the ball. We're going to call a timeout. Ooh. It's one of the rules as a coach sometimes you love because you're able to bail your players out, but as a player you hate because you had the time, you had the steal, and they did the timeout. I think we need to go to FIBA rules where the players are the only ones that can call timeout. So quick timeout here for the Tigers. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Okay, we're back out of the timeout. We'll see what LCC is able to draw up coming here. They've extended their lead to 4 points, 50 to 46. Again, Ethan Bauer has really hurt the G-men tonight. He's got 23 points, but he has been complimented by Patrick Miller, who has 14. So nice 1-2 punch there. Good defense by Spade. Into Anson Graham, dumps it down to Miller, who's going to back down, kick out to Jaber, thinks better of it. Graham inside, kicks it back to Jaber, again, thinks better of it. And there's Beiler. Beiler with the ball. Nice 1-2 step. No, doesn't fall. So, again, I think both game plans can be to take the ball inside. Demma's third foul there. So, not real sure if this turns into a free throw contest. Who's going to win? Both teams are about 60% on the night. So Kobe Beiler shooting two after that foul. Beiler's first shot, no good. And Spade was trying to steal one here, hiding back in the corner down here off camera, but LCC was able to see him. Beiler hits the second of two. And the Tigers are up five as we go under 3.5 minutes to go, and that ball is thrown away off off Janik's hands. And here comes our defensive pressure. Again, trying to get Bauer to work. Here comes the double team. And trying to keep Bauer. Again, make him work up and down the floor. Let anybody other than Bauer bring it up. And there's where that's why you want to. Jaber toss away to Janik. Janik blows the layup. Bauer quickly down the floor and jump stop again. Floater, good. Again, he has a whole repertoire here. Okay. G-men down seven, under 3 minutes to go. Need a defensive stop. Need a score here. Any type of score. Gideon with a clean look. Nice pump fake, good runner. Nice shot by Tristan. And we got a quick timeout by Coach Oleski. So good answer there by Gideon. Gideon's come alive this quarter for 6 points. After a fast start, he's up to 15. G-men have cut into this lead. It is a 5-point lead now, under 3 minutes to go. Again, both teams, if they run their offense, are going to work clock. G-men need to continue, at least from what we've seen. They can continue to drive the ball. They can continue to drive the ball to the basket. They have gotten good looks. Gideon's hit some floaters. Dema has been able to get it inside. Spade at times has taken it inside, but he's also hit his outside jumper. He's one to kind of keep an eye on. He's been quiet for the last couple possessions. Hasn't scored this quarter. So offensively for LCC, it's probably going to run through Bauer, obviously. But the G-men know that, so of course they're going to do what they can to get somebody else to step up. So after the timeout, LCC does have the baseline to run. They don't. Bauer gets the sidelines, cuts it back to the middle. There's the pass to Graham, almost turned over, and he's going to go to jump ball, and it's going to stay with the Tigers. Again, if you can get the ball out of Bauer's hand, the others don't seem to be as apt with the ball. Bauer letting the defender blow right by him. Here comes the trap. Nope, they're going to stay straight up on him. And there's Jaber, who's nice block by Swagonski, but Jaber gets it back. Kind of surprised at the no call there, but I think I would have rather had the call and had him shooting free throws than to let him get it back and put it back up. Jaber up to 8 points all here in the second half. Good look to Swagonski. And three. Again, he hit those the other night against Mogador. 4-point game. And there's the steal, though. We're going to get a foul. Foul is on Dema. That's Dema's fourth. So if this game stays tight, that's a hurtful foul there. He's got four. Swagonski's got three. But on the other side, three players for LCC have three fouls. 1-1 opportunity here for Jaber. Makes the first. And misses the second, ripped down by Janik. And again, G-men don't need a three. They can take the ball inside. Gideon's had good success in driving the basketball. Don't want those types of passes. Dema's been able to get inside. Swagonski's just hit a three. Good take by Swagonski. No good. Rebound by Graham. Graham down the floor. He's going to get trapped, and he's going to wing it down the floor to Beiler. Beiler to Bauer. Bauer with the little floater. Good. Bauer's up to 27 on the night. Tipped away there by Beiler, and a foul on Beiler. And that is Kobe's first foul of the night, and their fifth as a team. Minute 20 to go. Again, still not panic mode, but now it might be. Jaber's going to go in for the layup, and he's going to get it. Going to get something on that. Followed up by Graham, correct?
Yes.
Graham's first basket of the night pushes it to a 9-point lead as we approach 1 minute to go. And there's good take by Dema. No good. Miller with the rebound to Bauer. And now the G-men got a foul. And there's the foul on Gideon. That's Gideon's first. Team sixth. And Bauer is set to the line. One thing we have, we haven't seen him do tonight, but the one thing's been that he hasn't done well tonight is shoot free throws. 3 for 5 tonight. But if you're Coach Bright, that's who I probably want at the free throw line. And he hits the first. It's up to a 10-point lead here. So what, Cam, what was the you remember score at the end of the third quarter? It was a 4-point game, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I know it was 29-25 Tigers at halftime, so.
Yeah, it's Tigers have definitely exploded. This was, for those of you that were at Hartville last weekend, this was a 38-33 ball game that the G-men were victorious in. Gideon with probably one of his first clean looks. Both misses here, and the Tigers are going to walk out of G-ville with a victory. Question's just going to be what the margin's going to be. But, yeah, so it was a 38-33 victory for the G-men last weekend. And that is Demma's fifth foul. So Anthony Demma has fouled out. Eric Geddes checks back in. Tigers were up 20-11 last week at half. This week they were up 29-25 at halftime, I believe. I could check my math, but it's not there. So Beiler with the miss. If he follows the last pattern of him going to the free throw line, he'll make this one. He's been miss, make, miss. So we'll see what pattern he has here. Second free throw, good. So he follows his pattern, miss, make. And it's a 12-point lead for the Tigers. Spade with a three, no good. Rebound by Beiler. Beiler is going to be fouled by Janik. That's Janik's third. Again, Janik picked up those first two early in the first half. So probably good for both these teams that they're not playing back-to-back. I do believe both teams are off tomorrow. Not sure in this age of COVID with everybody's schedule is all wacky with playing back-to-backs and stuff. So Beiler keeps his pattern. Miss, make. He misses. So will he make this one? Should I go to Vegas or not? I should go to Vegas because he's miss, make, miss. So clock rolling. Swagonski's shot is blocked. Miller with the rebound. And again, the Tigers will walk out of here with a 64-51 victory. It's a good game by both teams. Boys are back in action at home next Tuesday. Do not remember off the top of my head who they're playing, but I do know next week, two games, they are home. Girls are on the road all week, so it will not be a girls' stream for a while. But we appreciate you listening, and hopefully we can continue this. We'll talk to you next week. Tune in. Bye-bye.